Hello and welcome back to another one of my videos. My name is Danae, aka also known as Queen Aries 0325. And I am the founder and creator, mastermind, one woman band for Inlaying Inspirations candle company, where I make soy based candles. That doesn't sound right. Soy wax candles. So yes, I make 10-ounce candles, 2-ounce candles, 4-ounce candles. I'm playing around with a lot of candles, as you can tell, of sizing, even 10-ounce candles. Like, for instance, this one. I recently got a little creative and wanted to put my little spin on everything. And I did a paw print for like a lost pets. For anybody who has lost a pet or anything like that, I got inspired with this candle. Shout out to my fiance, CJ, for asking me or coming to me with the idea. So I got creative and I made a couple of these, which I might sell at the Juneteenth event, which is what we're about to talk about and what this video consists of. But before then, I want to say Happy Pride Month! It is June and it is Pride Month and your girl is part of the LGBTQ. Anyway, if those who are new here and don't know, I am gay and happy. But we're not gonna get into my sexuality. If you wanna know about it, maybe I can make another video about that. But on to another note, wanna give that a shout out. And then I've noticed and been learning that there is a lot of Black history going on. Like, it's Black Music Month, where Black artists get a spotlight on them and things like that. So on Amazon Prime, I've been watching a lot of videos of singers and so on, getting to know a little bit about their life and how they came about, which is very motivating, by the way, for a creative person myself with this business and stuff and trying to find a way to stand out in my business. And I think I'm getting pretty close to doing just that, finding my creative spark and what works for me. And I'm finding what works for me and what makes me stand out. So back to the video and what this is going to be about. It's pretty much a vlog video where I pretty much give you insight backstage of what is going to be going on, because like I said, I will be recording my first event. I just actually got an email, a notification that I have got my peddler license for the 2 days of this event as well. Sorry about that in the background. But yes, we are me, my fiance, my future mother-in-law, and then my sister and her fiance plan on helping me out with selling my candles. So this is gonna be like a quick video because I do have to get ready for work soon. I'm always working. I'm always doing something. Never rest. What is rest for? I don't know. But anyway, I'm on a mission in life. But on another note, I got a mess on my table as always, as I always say in every vlog video. I got a mess on my table, but I wanted to show you guys me kind of cleaning it up, me getting the inventory out, seeing what I need to make sure. I have a list of things that I want to sell, so I need to make sure that they are in their final stage and they've been curing for a good enough time that they'll be ready to go to sell. I also have to finish, which I'll probably do tonight, so this might be a longer video. I'm not sure. We'll see how it goes. But I have wax melts of different scents, of some sample candles that I did, so this is going to have to get packaged and things like that. And oh my god, it smells so good. And this is also a different, I got different wax too. So I no longer do the 444. It's way too soft. And I kind of don't like it because this has been sitting for a while. This is 464. And I don't really get a lot of frosting on this. Like, see, there's barely any frosting. As to where is it at? These candle right here, it's called frosting. I don't like this too much. I like how soft the wax is and oily it is, but, and then as you can see, as I was breaking it out, I have a lot of leftover pieces And my room is not very insulated very well, so I needed something that would be just a little bit harder because it is summertime and this is all too soft for summer. So I had to switch up my wax, which you can see this is actually a good comparison because this is 464 right here, all these tan ones, and then this is 444 wax right here. So you see the difference? Not too much frosting, way too much frosting. So I needed something a little harder, which will also make my wax melts not crumble as well either. I got feedback on when somebody, and also found out at the same time of researching about wax melts, that they crumble easy. So I'm like, I don't want that. I want a clean thing because not everybody's going to be like, oh, little bits of wax everywhere and I got to clean that up. And then you get your hands all oily because soy wax is very oily sometimes. Well, it is. Don't listen to me. Sometimes it is. It's oily when you touch it. But this one is not so oily. This one, very, very oily. Like, you still get a little residue of it. So, yeah. I'm still going to use these as freebies. So, let's go on into showing you the cleaning and the inventory I got going on and what else I need to get done because June 18th is going to be here faster than I know. And now that I have, that I got the pet owner license, I am ready to freaking go. So let's get into it. Also, if you're new here, make sure you subscribe and hit that bell notification so you don't miss out on any videos. I know I've been gone for the ones who were here. I know I've been gone for a minute on YouTube, but your girl, life, that's all I'm gonna say. Life for right now. Maybe we'll get into it in this video, me talking about it. But make sure you hit that subscribe button, notification, and share with somebody you know that loves candles and wants to see or get motivation of a business coming, you know, starting out on their own. Don't mind that. When I was doing my experimental work, my kids bothered me about brushing their teeth. I have yet to put it back in the bathroom. So yes, we need to clean all this up. Table is all clean, rainy. These scratches. Now that the table is all clean, we're going to get my inventory for Juneteenth. I want to visually see if I have enough candles for over the next 2 days. Because there's going to be a lot of people here. And I'm thinking big numbers. So hopefully I have enough. So I'm going to bring those out right now. This right here is my free samples, which I still don't feel like I have enough of. I also have some thank you stickers. Thank you for supporting my business. And these are for the freebie bags. I hope I don't run out. I might end up just toss them in the bag afterwards. Sorry for that. My fiance just got home. I also have like freebies of soap that I actually can still sell that I made not long ago. I think I might still take these out. I'm not sure. But yeah. And then I have stuff I used to make. Just rough stuff. That's freebies too that I'm trying to get rid of that are too pretty that I didn't want to throw away. So, and they still smell really good. So these are the freebies that I'm going to give, like I said. There's that. I'm going to put that over here. I still don't have enough. I still got like two trays to go through, plus these extra paw prints that I had. I'll show you. These paw prints are going to be also in the freebie bin too as well. Next up are my wax melts that I have left that did not get sold. I have those. Can I put this in here? I'm trying to be gentle here. Oh my god, this box smells so good. Okay, I can put that in there. So these two can't fit. But yeah, these are all the wax melts that I have. Now, I do want to say that I do not have a pegboard where I can like hang these up. So you will probably, when I do another event vlog video, you might see me grab last minute stuff for my stand. I'm gonna see if I can find something at Michael's or whatever and see if I can find something where I can stand these up. But I have those. I almost dropped these babies. But this is candles that I have. Like my relax candles, my unicorn one, anything, my last amber and Egyptian amber one. And then I also have a couple of Eat Me's left. And then ones I didn't post on the shop that I made specifically for this event. This is the amber tiki wood. And it smells fantastic, but this is what that one is. My mermaid edition. I went a little mermaid crazy, so I have a good bit of these. I have about 5 of these. Yeah, so I have those. The other one must be in the other box. So I have these ready to go. Hopefully I don't drop the other box. You're what?
I'm leaving. Bye.
That was my oldest coming to ask me a question. So anyway, here's my other one. Everybody just wants to bother me today. Well, hello, babe.
Hi.
You and the kids.
Oh. Well. Do you want that?
Thank you.
I said some, not all.
Okay. That's enough. That's enough.
Damn.
I didn't even Stevie. Get anything.
I'm just kidding. Here you go.
Why does your breast smell like popcorn?
Because Lonnie's eating popcorn.
She made a popcorn by herself?
No. She asked me for it when I got in.
Oh.
Y'all like my shirt? Looney Tunes. Thank you.
As I was trying to say, this box here is filled with all different types of candles, and I have to go through and label these. So this box still needs labeled. Gotta love the family. Stop. She's walking by like a weirdo now. Anyway, I these ones don't need labeled. They're already done. Yeah, see, these ones are already labeled, so I have to go through and do these again. So that's what I'm going to do when I get home from work. I'm going to be tired for a couple of days because they need cleaned off and everything still too. So, and then I have little little tiny ones that are 2 ounces. We gotta get a double check. On those, I have those that need to still be done. Now, I have these jars for anybody who buys like over $100 worth of stuff, but I don't like the presentation of it. I don't like the presentation of it. So I think I might try to decorate it with some stickers. Like make it look a lot nicer. I have some tape that I could tape this up, but I don't like it. So I think I might just take these out and make more samples out of them. I'm still deciding if I want to do this or not. I might try and do it because they're just like clamshells, but the 440 wax, like see how oily it is, it scrapes and it leaves stuff, and I'm just not happy with that. So I'm probably gonna be playing around with a lot of wax till I find wax that I like. So we have that, and then at least my 2 ounces as well. I have 2 ounces down here and 2 ounces right here. And these two, they have their warning, some of them have their warning labels on, but I still need to label them, which I remember what these scents are by color and things like that. So, but yeah. Ooh, that's a nice one right there. That's that coconut. It smells a little marshmallowy, but it's a coconut one. And they need cleaned up too, so gotta get those done. And that's basically pretty much all the inventory I have that I'm hoping will last me 2 days. But if not, I also have the tiki wood. No, this isn't tiki wood. This is, yeah, the Norel and jazz, white jasmine. I'm adding these two as well. Almost forgot. And then I'll be adding these little 2 ounce samples of cactus and jade. I already know what these are. 2 of sage and lemongrass. So I have those, which I need to label. I should label those. Lavender and amethyst, like real crystals inside. These are 8 ounce jars. So I have those in there. And it smells great. I might have to cut some wicks down. So I'm gonna have to go through and make sure that these are like really, really ready to go. Mix them up a little bit, so. I have those. So this whole entire table is filled with candles. I'm hoping it'll be enough. And then I'm kind of secretly hoping it's not enough and I gotta come back to the drawing board, you know? We are going to see if all this is enough, because then I hope to be able to buy my desk. I hope to buy more oils. Also my fall oils I need, because these are the new tins. Little sneak peek. These are the new tins that, shout out to my mother-in-law. I found some tins online, showed her the pictures, and she bought them for me. So I kind of like sticking with the gold, white, and black theme. I'm loving the gold, white, and black. So I might stick with those. And these tins, I'm gonna show you, hold on. They're gold inside. One of my customers said they really like the gold effect when they unpackage my boxes. So I'm like, you know what, gold, white, and black, I can stick with that. I like it. It seems very classy in my pictures that I do. I'm gonna show a picture. I do like a black portrait look in the background to be a little classic, more classic look. I'm working on trying to give you a classic picture look, but also give you a store picture as well. So whenever you're shopping, so you don't think you're looking for artwork, you actually get to see the candle as what it is without any of the filters and things like that. You know, the pretty, pretty stuff. So I'm going to be revising my whole website again on how everything looks. If I sell out of stuff that's on my website, I will completely take all of my inventory off and then flood it with other inventory stuff, you know? So I'm excited. I'm ready. So this will pretty much be day one's worth. I also need to work on day two worth, just in case this is, you know, I'm out of things. So I need to prepare for anything, pretty much. So it's gonna be a tireful week. It really is. So I got some 8 ounce tins. I got still some more 4 ounce tins, and I still have 2 ounce tins, just in case I need to fill those up. And whatever I use is gonna go right back into investing into my business. That is the goal, that is the plan. So that way I can get another 464 wax, and then get my fall oils, maybe work on getting my Christmas oils. I want some different silicone molds, so I might do that. There's a couple of things I need to buy extra of. I also want to try and sampling some different types of wicks. I want to try and move on to different type of wicks for the candles. So basically that's kind of what this whole first event is going to be, to invest back into my business, and I'm highly excited. So hopefully next time I can actually shoot from my desk. That's the main thing. I want to buy a desk. So that'll be it. So here on out, for the rest of this video, we are just going to go through and label candles. And I thank you so far for watching. And I also remind you again, if you're new here and you made it this far, please subscribe to this channel so you don't miss out on any of the videos, because you never know, clearly, of today, what's going to happen in a video with my family and all that. So you don't want to miss out. Here we go. Okay, I'm gonna have to cut this video short. Well, it's not short. I'm gonna have to cut the video from where it is because it's going to be way too long to show you that I had to go through and reheat some of these tops up and things like that and make sure the wicks were cut down to the appropriate length. Ooh, that smells really good. Anyway, so yeah, I have to cut the video because I'm already really far into it. Talking about the products and stuff. So you'll have to stay tuned to a part two video of the event that is coming up this weekend in the PNG Park. I keep wanting to say PNGC, but it's just PNG Park. It's the People's Natural Gas Park and downtown in the area of Johnstown. So if you are local and you're watching this in the area that I live in, come check it out because it has been having great events going on all week long for Juneteenth. So come on down, get some great, there's great food there. I'm telling you, I can't wait to get down there. I'm actually gonna go down there Thursday and see everything and visualize where I wanna set up and stuff like that. So yes, go ahead. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell notification, so that way you don't miss out on the part two video, okay? What you doing? What you doing? And with all that being said, if no one told you yet today they love you, I honestly hold space for saying I love you, and I hope you have a fantastic day. Stay tuned.